I decided to share something with you today that happened in this last miniature that I'm painting. I'm not happy. I'm not happy with the attempted scroll work I did here. Let's see, looks kind of uneven and so on. I tried to get fancy with it this time and I'm just not happy. My point on it is, if you're going to become a better miniature painter, you can't be afraid to try some of these things. And don't give up if it sucks. Don't give up if it if it's not to your liking. For me, I'm going to thinly go over this again. Now, there's a fair bit of effort put into shading this cloak. I don't know if you can see, the camera really doesn't show, but there's probably about 5 or 6 different blends to go from the deep brown up to the white here. So there's a fair bit of effort in covering this back up, reshading the cloak, and then putting this trim. But I just wanted to share with you that everybody makes mistakes. Sometimes the videos that you see online are always the best work that people show. Nobody likes showing their errors, and I'm one of them. I don't like showing this what I'd like to think is crap, but hopefully some of you guys get something out of it so that you're not afraid to try some of these, let's say, advanced techniques or whatever is advanced for your level. You know, anybody can start something. It's the guys that finish. That's when you get the results. So for me, I'm just going to go over this, reshade the inside of the cloak, and probably do something a little bit more simple. Just for the fact of, I don't want to go over it again in case I make a mistake. And this miniature is fairly well along, so I don't want to dip them. So I'm going to use a little bit of a strategy in how I try or do some of these techniques, but I just want to share on, don't be afraid to try something in the event that you fail. It's just, you're just going to have to do it again. Just make mention to these miniatures. Thank you so much for the comments, guys, on what you thought of the scroll work. I'm not going to peel the scroll work off. Some people liked it. I did want a little bit of a flow to it, but because the rod goes straight down, there would have to be so much scroll work to make that happen. Some guys made the suggestions, and I'm fully in agreement that next time I will drill the post on this angle so that the post would sit like that. And then I would put some guitar wires and scroll work mixed in and so on. But live and learn, like, there's a fair bit of work that went into making these scrolls. And I'm still happy with this. Like, in one, some people wanted to see the scrolls behind like it was moving. Well, I think I've seen a couple videos online, either from video games or even from the Warhammer movie, where these servo skulls are just floating. They're just stationary. So, in my imagination, these are just stationary. But just another example, don't be afraid to try something. Because it took a fair bit of work to do the green stuff, let it dry, and then even more work to apply the paint to see the overall outcome. And you know, if I didn't like it, I'm peeling off all that work and starting over. But I'm okay with the result, so that's why I'm going to keep them. But live and learn. I'm hoping to find a couple more of these metal servo skulls, because I'd like to make more. These are great objective holders, and the detail on these little things are just extremely cool. So hopefully you guys got something out of it. Out of this short video, guys, I want you to learn from my mistakes, but also learn from, I guess, if I can say, my guts, to try this stuff and try and move my modeling and painting forward. Cheers, guys. Please leave a comment if you got something out of this or what your feedback is. I'd appreciate it. Bye-bye.